Josh Boone, here we are again. Last time we talked was Comic-Con at home. I am extremely excited. We are a second close, or we're a little closer to New Mutants finally being released in theaters and for everybody to see it finally. I got to ask you, what appealed to you about the New Mutants when you first came on to the project?
Well, it's like we really brought the project to Fox. I wrote it with my best friend, Nate, who I grew up with. And we had loved the comic book series when we were kids. And I, even when I moved to LA, 10 years before I ever had made movies, I had a stack of these comics in my apartment. And I just knew that Bill Sienkiewicz's art was incredible. Yes. It looked different than anything I'd ever seen in a comic book before when I was a kid in the 1980s. So much closer to like Vertigo art or like the really dark DC art that was coming out at the time. We just wanted to bring his artwork to life is sort of what the idea started with. And I always loved that it seems so much more like a Nightmare on Elm Street than an X-Men thing.
Yes.
It seems so much that like Dani was hanging between life and death while her friends fought for her and all that. I just wanted to try to get as much of that stuff in as I could. I don't know. I mean, that's basically was the process, just trying to get as much in as you can. And then as the budget comes down, you squeeze more and more out until it's the movie, you know?
Now, when you guys kind of pitched this idea, was there, you guys always had this affinity for the Demon Bear back in the day?
Yeah, I mean, to me, that was the most representative of New Mutants and what made New Mutants special. They didn't have costumes on. The artwork pushed the frames of the panels more than I'd ever seen on a page before. And dude, they were young in a way that movies aren't now, where it's like superhero movies star adults.
Right,
they don't
star
kids. So it's like, we really wanted to make a teen movie. We really wanted it to have coming of age elements and dramatic elements and a romance in it as well as all this other stuff. So,
Speaking of teenage drama and teenage movie and superheroes, they're such a compatible genre. Can you talk to me about why they fit so well together?
Because that's when mostly these people began reading these things. You know, it's like you read them when you were a kid and you probably read them when you were a teenager as well. And like, I don't know, man, we're all looking for ways to escape high school life sometimes. I can remember being in high school, and I think everybody from the most popular kid to the least probably felt like an outsider to some degree.
Right.
So as well as trying to make a movie for young adults who felt like outsiders, which I hope is all of them, you know, and even other people as well. I already know comic book fans and X-Men fans will go, but it was really written for young people to come and see themselves hopefully reflected in it.
Now, I know that you're a longtime fan, and I love seeing directors that are longtime fans get a chance to share their experience with a wider audience. Can you talk to me about which one of the New Mutants powers you would choose if you were one of them?
Dude, I would want to be Ileana. She's fucking awesome. I feel probably closest to Rain because she was raised by kind of oppressive Christians and she was in a kind of a strange situation. I sort of grew up raised by evangelical Christians in the 1980s. So it's like, I related to her a lot, but everybody wishes they could be the badass with the sword and the dragon, you know?
Right. Now, for a lot of teens, this is a scary time. And this is about a group of people stuck in a place trying to get out. And here we find ourselves in a quarantine, very much in the same situation. Can you talk to me about how timely this movie is coming out now?
It wasn't intentional. I mean, it was supposed to come out so long ago, but it's like, you could tell me that the universe wanted it to open now because now everybody's quarantined. And I would have been like, okay, I believe you because we just made the stand and the pandemic happened. So, you know, just in general, it's just a little bit eerie and spooky, but also too, it's like, it's coming out when it's supposed to come out. I think things tend to, you know?
Right. Now, is there any other corner of the Marvel Universe that you would like to explore after New Mutants?
I mean, I don't know, man. I mean, I'd look at any opportunity that came my way. Our favorite character growing up more than any other was always Spider-Man. So it's like, we'll be like everybody else. Well, I wish we could make a Spider-Man movie. But it's like really my favorite thing I read every issue of it to my daughter when she was growing up was I do love Power Pack.
So it's I love Power Pack too.
I think like a kid's Marvel movie would be awesome with the aliens coming and all the dueling alien races and giving them their powers and all that. That would be so much fun.
I used to have to read that at my dentist office waiting to go in. It's Power Pack. That would always be there. Now, just out of curiosity, The Stand, I just recently watched it, like the whole thing for the Stephen King, and I've read the book in the past.
You watched the McCarris version. Yeah.
Yes, I had
it. When we were kids and that came out, it was the most watched TV miniseries in the history of network television. I taped it on VHS when I was a kid. I remember watching it over and over and being like, oh my God, it's so good. So I love Mick Garris as the Stand. It meant a lot to us when we were kids. Even if you look at like the technical limitations now or things like that, it still holds you because the story is so good.
Right. I can't wait to see what you do with it, because the reason I watched it back was because here we are in a pandemic. It's about a super flu. And there's so many, this kind of thing's almost following you, right, Josh? I feel like
I choose much more carefully what I make next time. I need to make like something like a period piece or something set. I don't know. I'm not sure. I just don't want to do anything else to the world. But The Stand was cool. It's like, so The Stand, I mean, The Stand took years. It's like, it started as a movie at Warner Brothers. I carried a lot of cast members along the way to CBS, found amazing showrunners who did a lot of the day-to-day and all that once the development was done. And, you know, I directed the first episode and the last episode and wrote the first one with Ben, the other showrunner. And really the last episode Stephen King wrote. So we had sort of an hour of original material by Stephen King that was a story set after The Stand. That was a story that he'd always wanted to tell. So I got to sort of open it and close it and then go finish New Mutants while the rest of it got made.
I'm literally getting CBS All Access just for The Stand, just to let you know. I can't.
Everybody's going to have to, and they're going to have, they all will, because this, the cast and the, it's just, it's an awesome show.
Now, speaking
I'm excited
of
for people to see it.
You and me both. Now, speaking of New Mutants, here we are closer to the release. It's almost here. How does it finally feel to have the fans come and see this film?
I mean, I'm just really glad that it's, the fans have really kept it alive in a lot of ways with all the amazing artwork that they've done online and just with like all the positive messages that they've sent us. And like, they've been so positive about the footage we have shown them that I feel like they do really feel like we did justice to the characters, which I feel that they'll truly believe that. I'm just excited for people to get out of their houses and go to a movie instead of a party, or like to do something irresponsible instead, go to the movies. And I think people need to start going again. I think it's good to get out and see people and not get agoraphobic and not start to live like, I don't know, man. I just think there's a balance. It's like, we want to be safe and not get anybody sick, but we also shouldn't live in a fear culture, you know?
Right, right. Now, before the pandemic delayed the release, the movie business also shifted New Mutants release date. How have you had any talks with any other directors about this experience, or do you have any kind of like film delay advice or words of wisdom for people like Patty Jenkins or Christopher Nolan out there?
I've met Chris Nolan a couple times. He's been real nice to me. I was lucky enough to sit and have lunch with him once, and his wife. You know, my favorite director will always be Oliver Stone. It's like, my dad took me to see JFK when I was 12 and it changed my life. I know him a little bit. But, you know, some of my closest director friends are like Josh Trank, who went through a lot of the same things that he went through with Fantastic Four. So, like, you know, talk to him regularly. Like, he's one of the best guys around, no matter what a suit says about him. So,
right, right.
But just in general, it's like, you know, it's like he's a good guy. He had a real bad experience. And, you know, I mean, again, it's just like everybody goes through whatever. Ours was much less divisive, but but it's like it still was dealing with talented artistic people trying to deal with corporate structure, which is a very difficult thing to do.
Now, usually when, because this movie at its core is a horror film, and I usually, you hear a lot of stories about weird things happening on set and stuff like that. Did you experience that at all with New Mutants?
I mean, I didn't personally experience it, but I had several crew members have very strange, anomalous experiences happened to them. And I would rush to where it happened and be like, dear God, tell me if there's life after death. If there's a ghost, touch me. And then nobody ever would. So like, I was like Fox Mulder, always getting to the case after it was already done.
You're like, unfortunately, it didn't happen to me.
Dude, give me a ghost to show, possess me, give me something. I want to know if there's something else or not. So it's like that all is interesting to me. There were a couple of crew members who like wanted to be walked back to their cars at night because they just were so creeped out. They had like ghostly whispers in their ears when they were by themselves up in places, putting lights up where it was like somebody right next to their ear. You know, people really shaken by it who like were really freaked out. So I certainly respect people who've had experiences like this. The whole of human history is filled with them.
Sure.
But I have yet for anybody to care enough to nudge me.
I love it. Well, look, I can't wait for people to see your vision of what the New Mutants is, because I feel like It's the vision that I've always wanted as well. So thank really you
our,
so much.
Truly, thank you. Our vision. I mean, the cast and myself and Nate and everybody and Peter Deming, like we all worked really hard on it, just like The Stand or anything else. It's a lot more than just me that that makes any of it happen.
Well, I can't wait for The Stand. I can't wait to see Stu Redman and Nick Andrew. So I'm super excited, man. Thank you so much for your time. I can't wait to see New Mutants. Thank you very much.